We may have to rewrite all the textbooks about the beginning of the universe.
One of the mysteries of our galaxy and every other are globular clusters, dense groupings of up to a million stars. The most massive and oldest star clusters in the known universe. Astronomy enthusiasts would know how beautiful these look when viewed through even a small telescope. If you live in the Northern Hemisphere, in summertime, you can see these ancient relics appear along the Orion spiral arm. Be it the Sagittarius star cluster, the Omega Centauri, or any of the other 177 visible stars around the halo of our Milky Way. It is known that a lot about globular clusters remains unanswered by astronomers. What are they? Where did they come from? Answers have eluded astronomers for centuries, but new images by the James Webb Space Telescope could finally solve the mystery of these ancient clusters. A theory that, if correct, could land another blow to our cosmological model.
Orbit beyond the blue.
According to a research paper published in Astronomy and Astrophysics, researchers claim to have found the first chemical trace of supermassive stars in globular proto-clusters existing about 440 million years after the Big Bang. These supermassive stars are extraordinarily huge, about 5,000 to 10,000 times more massive and 5 times hotter than our Sun. Finding traces of such stars is complicated by the fact that supermassive stars burn fast and die young, unlike globular clusters. Globular clusters are between 10 and 13 billion years old, whereas the maximum lifespan of superstars is 2 million years. They therefore disappeared very early from the clusters that are currently observable. Only indirect traces remain. One of James Webb's images of one of the most distant and youngest galaxies known to date in our universe is GNZ 11, which was first identified in 2016 by Hubble. It is a few tens of millions of years old. Its light shows very high levels of nitrogen, which, the authors say, can only be explained by the combustion of hydrogen at extremely high temperatures. GNZ 11 also contains a very high density of stars. This all suggests that globular clusters are forming inside while a supermassive star still exists. It's a tantalizing clue as to the origin of these clumps of ancient stars. The cosmic dawn has now started to look like a bright cosmic afternoon full of possibilities. And with each new day, it seems, claims of yet another record-breaking earliest known galaxy emerge from one research group or another. In the weeks and months following Webb's findings of surprisingly mature early galaxies, blindsided theorists and observers alike have been scrambling to explain them.
The James Webb Telescope has identified 6 galaxies that exist half a billion years after the Big Bang, that are up to 10 times bigger than the Milky Way galaxy.
Could the bevy of anomalously big and bright early galaxies be illusory, perhaps because of flaws in analysis of the telescope's initial observations? If genuine, could they somehow be explained by standard cosmological models? Or, just maybe, were they the first hints that the universe is stranger and more complex than even our boldest theories had supposed? At stake is our very understanding of how the orderly universe we know emerged from the primordial chaos. James Webb's continued revelations could be set to rewrite the opening chapters of cosmic history, which concern not only distant and faraway galaxies, but also our existence here, in the familiar Milky Way. As light from a very distant galaxy travels across the cosmic abyss, it is stretched by the expansion of the universe, a broadening of wavelengths known as redshift. The higher the redshift value, the more stretching the light has experienced, and thus the more distant its source galaxy will be. Redshifts for early galaxies are so high that their emitted visible light has stretched into infrared by the time it arrives at our telescopes. Hubble's record for the most distant known galaxy has been GNZ 11, which we mentioned earlier in regards to the globular clusters. It was spotted in 2015, at a redshift of 11, thanks to a 2009 upgrade to the telescope that enhanced its modest infrared capabilities. A redshift of 11 corresponds to a cosmic age of about 400 million years, a point at the brink of when galaxy formation was thought to begin. But from the very first glass data in early Webb observations, scientists had found a candidate for a more distant galaxy, dubbed Glass 13, at a redshift of 13, some 70 million years farther back in time. The researchers depended on redshift estimates derived from simple brightness-based measurements. These are easier to obtain, but less precise than direct measurements of redshift, which require more dedicated observation time. Nonetheless, the simplified technique can be accurate, and here it suggested a galaxy that was unexpectedly bright and big, already bearing a mass of stars of a billion suns, just a few hundred times less than that of the Milky Way, despite our own galaxy being billions of years more mature. Such behemoths emerging so rapidly defies expectations set by cosmologists' standard model of the universe's evolution. Even if you took everything that was available to form stars and snapped your fingers instantaneously, you still wouldn't be able to get that big that early. To understand the dilemma, a brief refresher is needed. In a fraction of a second after the Big Bang, our universe was an unimaginably hot and dense soup of primordial particles. Over the next 3 minutes, as the cosmos expanded and cooled, the nuclei of helium and other very light elements began to form. Fast forward for 100,000 years, and the universe was cold enough for the first set of atoms to appear. When the universe was about 100 million years old, a baby universe, theorists say, conditions were finally right for the emergence of the first stars. These giant fireballs of mostly hydrogen and helium were as yet uncontaminated by heavier elements like modern-day stars, and thus possessed significantly different properties. Larger and brighter than today's stars, these first suns coalesced in proto-galaxies, clusters of gas that clung to vast, invisible scaffolds of dark matter. Gravity guided the subsequent interactions between these proto-galaxies, which eventually merged to form larger galaxies. This process of becoming, of the early universe chaos giving way to the more orderly cosmos we know today, is thought to have taken about a billion years. Webb's discovery of bright galaxies in the early cosmos challenges this very model. There's concern that some of these galaxies may be imposters, much closer galaxies shrouded in dust that makes them look dimmer and further away when brightness-based measurements are used. However, follow-up observations of Glass E13 in August 2022 by the Otacama Large Millimeter Array in Chile suggest that is not the case for this candidate, as ALMA did not see evidence for large amounts of dust. These results are shocking and hard to get in our standard model of cosmology. And it's probably not a small change. It's one that forces us back to the drawing board. The question now is, can we believe what we are seeing? Is it time to reevaluate our understanding of the dawn of time? The Big Bang theory? Or is it too early to break current cosmology? As ESA scientist Mark McCaffrey said, "You build these machines not to confirm the paradigm, but to break it. I suppose what we just don't know yet is how it will break. But then again, what do I know?"
Orbit. Beyond the blue.